Dear brothers and sisters, there is a sentiment that I want to immediately address that I think is on the hearts and minds of many people as we witness what is tragically unfolding in Gaza and in Palestine as a whole, in Palestine as a whole. And I want to mention the sentiment first so that you can understand bi-idhnillahi ta'ala where we are going as we start to navigate through the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to a moment that really resembles the moment that I believe much of us are in right now and the way that so many of us feel. And that is when you look around, you're at work, you look at what your corporations are saying, you look at what your favorite celebrities are saying, you're looking at what your politicians are saying, you're watching sporting events, you are seeing friends that you have on social media, and they are spewing some of the worst propaganda against the people of Palestine that you have ever seen. And you think to yourself, I thought this was a good person. You think to yourself, I thought this is someone that understood the plight of Muslims. I thought that this was someone who would not fall for the stereotypical racist framings about the Muslim community. I thought this was someone that could analyze a little bit deeper than the hoaxes and the propaganda that are out there. And there is a sense of loneliness. And that loneliness is even felt by our children when they go to school and even they're getting notices to stand with Israel. When they walk around and they see the entire American public seemingly, at least at the corporate level, one-sided. The President of the United States, completely one-sided. And there is a loneliness there. There is an estrangement there. So I'm going to mention to you the last ayah, which I feel like fits our moment right now. And inshallah ta'ala, we can take some of the lessons from it. إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ. People have gathered against you. Look, everybody is against you. There are too many people on the other side of that trench. فَخْشَوْهُمْ. So be afraid. أَيْخَافُوهُمْ. Be afraid. Now this last point that I want to get to in the Qur'an connects to the very first sentiment. And that is Khandaq, the battle of the trench. If there is any moment that resembles what is taking place with our brothers and sisters right now in Gaza, it is Khandaq. It actually is Khandaq. Because it is a time where a tactic was used to specifically starve off Medina, cut all supplies to them, to where even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him himself, walks around malnourished. Imagine, Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu said, I saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam walking around, he had stones tied to his stomach and he was bloated. Not the bloating after eating, the bloating of starvation. And it was 10,000 on the other side, 10,000 people that surrounded Medina from every direction, and they built this thin trench, only about 3 miles long. And between them and a massacre is this trench. And they are guarding every single point of that trench. They have to utilize every resource. You can't blink an eye. They were under siege for an entire month. Khandaq was a month. And the Meccans cut every single element of food and drink from reaching them in Medina. And so their food was running out, their water was running out, and they couldn't take breaks. The sleep, the lack of sleep was getting to them. And as they are guarding every single form of that trench, they also come to know that there are enemies from within, that there are those that are plotting to attack them from behind. Imagine the ru'b, imagine the fear that could penetrate you in those moments. I want you to picture yourself at that trench, and every few minutes there is an attempt on that trench. And you're guarding, you're guarding, you're guarding. Don't blink an eye. Don't go use the bathroom. You might mess up. Make sure that you don't miss. Make sure that you don't flinch. And at that point, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ النَّاسَ, that verily the people, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسِ, the people, the naysayers, the hypocrites said to them, إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ. Man, you guys are done. Look at you. Few desperate people at a trench. Your leader, the Prophet ﷺ, his stomach is poking out and bloated. Look at you. إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ. Look at all those people. You think you're going to survive this? فَخْشَوْهُمْ. Be afraid. You have no chance. All of the Arabs are gathering against you. And you're alone. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what? Allah did not send them angels that time that they could look at visibly and see divine aid in front of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that that increased them in faith. فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. That actually increased their faith. They were at a point in their spiritual maturity where when people said, look at all the people against you, it increased their faith. وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ. Said, you know what? Allah is enough for us. And He is the best of protectors. We've been with Allah long enough to know that Allah has not forsaken us. We are not afraid of the number on the other side. We are not afraid of the artillery. We're not afraid of the odds. There is nothing that you can say to shake us because we're a people of faith. We believe. We're not alone. We don't need to see 10,000 angels come down this time. We know, وَمَن نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ, that victory and help comes from Allah, that divine aid is on its way. Dear brothers and sisters, the people of Gaza are facing a genocide. It is a genocide that we have not seen the likes of for a very long time. And it is unfolding before the world's eyes. And the propagandists are doing everything they possibly can to hide the eyes of the American public, to hide the eyes of other people from that genocide, to justify it, to pollute. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned, لا يضرهم من خذلهم. These are a people that are not hurt by those who betray them. Because they have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now here's the thing. We can be inspired as we should be when we look at the people in Gaza and we look at the people of Palestine who have shown time and time again that the odds don't matter. The odds don't matter. But let's bring it back to us. Dear brothers and sisters, you are not behind the trench. You're not being starved. You're not having the water taken away from you. You don't have bombs dropping on you. Alhamdulillah. We have not been tested the way they've been tested. Different people are tested in different ways. Now there are people that will continue to die in this entire process. And as they die in this process, guess what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about Ashab al-Ukhdud, the people of the trench, not the people of Khandaq, that trench with the Prophet ﷺ, the people that were thrown into a trench and killed, ذلك الفوز الكبير, that they have succeeded. They attained success. They have held on to their covenant with Allah. They are now in paradise. Our dead are in paradise. We have no doubt about it. Every single one of our dead, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, that died on La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, that suffered in that cruelty and oppression, they're in paradise. Their victory has been attained. But then the people that are behind that trench and continuing to survive and refusing to go away, and us. If you look around and you feel alone and you feel like the odds are stacked, I want you to know that you have a responsibility. You might not be in the trench, but maybe you're one of the people on the outside of the trench that's trying to push people away, that's trying to make things easier for those behind the trench. Whatever platform you have, whatever voice you have, whatever money you have, whatever dua you have, when you use that for Allah, you are not alone. Because it wasn't just the people that were standing next to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that had the angels that were sent. وَمَن نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ, and victory is only from Allah. It was also the poet Hassan al-Thabit radiallahu ta'ala anhu who stood up and defended the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam against the smears of the hypocrites. There are multiple fronts to this. It's not just the physical front of that trench. You have a responsibility. And you have to do everything that you possibly can. And that is part of iman. That's part of faith. This isn't politics. That's part of faith when you see people being oppressed. And will there be consequences? Are our favorite politicians going to turn their backs on us? Are you maybe going to get a letter from your administration at a university? Are you going to get slapped on the wrist? Will you have certain consequences that will be faced? Is your social media going to be taken down? Maybe. Who cares? Who cares? People are carrying their dead babies and saying Alhamdulillah and La ilaha illallah, knowing that victory comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who cares if we face consequences for trying to be their voice outside of the trench? And if people say, Inna nasa qad jama'u lakum, look, Palestine is a losing battle. Palestine is not a losing battle. Palestine will win, insha'Allah ta'ala. Palestine will win, Gaza will win, Al-Aqsa will be liberated. We have as much certainty in that as we do when we say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadan Rasulullah, that wa man nasru illa min indillah. That victory and help only comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will win. They will win. When? Ala inna nasrullahi qareeb. When Allah wants it to happen. But it will happen.
Introducing the One Islam TV app, the ultimate destination to learn about Islam with hundreds of educational videos, lessons, and documentaries. Experience our 7 YouTube channels in one place. All content is music-free. Download the One Islam TV app now from the Apple or Google Play Store today.